This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Free Soil Party was a short-lived political party in the United States active in the 1848 and 1852 presidential elections, and in some state elections founded in Buffalo, New York. It was a third party and a single-issue party that largely appealed to and drew its greatest strength from New York State. The party leadership consisted of anti-slavery former members of the Whig Party and the Democratic Party. Its main purpose was to oppose the expansion of slavery into the Western territories, arguing that free men on free soil comprised a morally and economically superior system to slavery. It opposed slavery in the new territories, agreeing with the Wilmot Proviso, and sometimes worked to remove existing laws that discriminated against freed African Americans in states such as Ohio. It nominated Martin Van Buren for the presidency in 1848 and John P. Hale for the presidency in 1852. The party membership was largely absorbed by the Republican Party between 1854 and 1856, by way of the anti-Nebraska movement. Contents: 1. Positions. 2. History. 3. Legacy. 4. Presidential candidates. 5. Other noted free soilers. 6. See also. 7. References. 8. Further reading. 9. External links. Positions in this 1850 political cartoon, the artist attacks abolitionist, free soil, and other sectionalist interests of 1850 as dangers to the Union. Free soil candidates ran on a platform that declared, "We inscribe on our banner, free soil, free speech, free labor and free men, and under it we will fight on and fight ever, until a triumphant victory shall reward our exertions." The party also called for a tariff for revenue only, i.e. import taxes sufficient to meet federal government expenses without creating protectionist trade barriers, and for a Homestead Act. The Free Soil Party's main support came from areas of Ohio, upstate New York and western Massachusetts, although other northern states also had representatives. The party contended that slavery undermined the dignity of labor and inhibited social mobility, and was therefore fundamentally undemocratic, viewing slavery as an economically inefficient, obsolete institution. Free soilers believed that slavery should be contained, and that if contained it would ultimately disappear history. 1848 cartoon for Van Buren. In 1848 the New York State Democratic Convention did not endorse the Wilmot Proviso, an act that would have banned slavery in any territory conquered by the United States in the Mexican War. Almost half the members, known as barnburners, walked out after denouncing the national platform. Lewis Cass, the Democratic Party's 1848 presidential nominee, supported popular sovereignty, local control for determining the status of slavery in the U.S. territories. This stance repulsed the New York State Democrats and encouraged them to join with anti-slavery conscience Whigs and the majority of the Liberty Party to form the Free Soil Party, which was formalized in the summer of 1848 at conventions in Utica and Buffalo. The Free Soilers nominated former Democratic President Martin Van Buren for president, along with Charles Francis Adams for vice president, at Lafayette Square in Buffalo, then known as Courthouse Park. The main party leaders were Salmon P. Chase of Ohio and John P. Hale of New Hampshire. The Free Soil candidates won 10% of the popular vote in 1848 but no electoral votes, in part because the nomination of Van Buren discouraged many anti-slavery Whigs from supporting them. The party distanced itself from abolitionism and avoided the moral problems implicit in slavery. Members emphasized instead the threat slavery would pose to free white labor and northern businessmen in the new western territories, although abolitionist William Lloyd Garrison derided the party philosophy as white monism. The approach appealed to many moderate opponents of slavery. The 1848 platform pledged to promote limited internal improvements, work for a homestead law, work towards paying off the public debt, and introduce a moderate tariff for revenue only. The Compromise of 1850 temporarily neutralized the issue of slavery and undercut the party's no-compromise position. Most barnburners returned to the Democratic Party, while most of the conscience Whigs returned to the Whig Party. This resulted in the Free Soil Party becoming dominated by ardent anti-slavery leaders. The party ran John P. Hale in the 1852 presidential election, but its share of the popular vote shrank to less than 5%. However, 2 years later, after enormous outrage over the Kansas-Nebraska Act of 1854, the remains of the Free Soil Party helped form the Republican Party legacy. The Free Soil Party sent 2 senators and 14 representatives to the 31st Congress, which convened from March 4, 1849 to March 3, 1851. Since there were party members on the floor of Congress, they could could carry far more weight in the government and in the debates that took place. The Free Soil Party presidential nominee in 1848, Martin Van Buren, received 291,616 votes against Zachary Taylor of the Whigs and Lewis Cass of the Democrats, but Van Buren received no electoral votes. The party's spoiler effect in 1848 may have helped Taylor into office in a narrowly contested election. The strength of the party, however, was its representation in Congress. The 16 elected officials had influence far beyond their numerical strength. The party's most important legacy was as a route for anti-slavery Democrats to join the new Republican coalition in August 1854. An alliance was brokered at Ottawa, Illinois, between the Free Soil Party and the Whigs, in part based on the efforts of local newspaper publisher Jonathan F. Linton, that gave rise to the Republican Party. Free Soil Township, Michigan, was named after the Free Soil Party in 1848. Presidential candidates. Year. Presidential candidate. Vice presidential candidate 1, lost 1848. Martin Van Buren. Charles Francis Adams lost 1852. John P. Hale. George W. Julian lost. Other noted Free Soilers. Jonathan Blanchard, president of Knox College. Walter Booth, U.S. Congressman from Connecticut. David C. Broderick, U.S. Senator from California. William Cullen Bryant. Salmon P. Chase, U.S. Senator from Ohio. Orrin B. Cheney, legislator from Maine, founder of Bates College. Richard Henry Dana Jr. Sidney Edgerton, U.S. Congressman from Ohio, Chief Justice of the Idaho Territorial Supreme Court and Territorial Governor of Montana. John C. Fremont, U.S. Senator from California. Leander F. Frisbee, Wisconsin Attorney General. Joshua Reed Giddings, U.S. Congressman from Ohio. Francis Gillette, U.S. Senator from Connecticut. James Harlan, U.S. Senator from Iowa. Thomas Hoyne, future mayor of Chicago. Horace Mann, U.S. Congressman from Massachusetts and educational reformer. J. Young Scammon, Chicago pioneer and state Whig leader, who in 1848 ran on a free soil plank in the 4th Congressional District. William B. Ogden, former mayor of Chicago and president of the Galena and Chicago Union Railroad. Charles Sumner, U.S. Senator from Massachusetts. Walt Whitman, member of the Free Soil Committee for Brooklyn and editor of the Brooklyn Freeman, a Free Soil newspaper. John Greenleaf Whittier. Henry Wilson. Asa Walker. Victor Willard, Wisconsin State Senator, 17th District, 1849-50, and Wisconsin Constitutional Convention Delegate, 1846. Dem Willard Woodard, educator, publisher, Free Soil Club co-founder and president. See also Second Party System. Origins of the American Civil War. Appeal of the Independent Democrats. Anti-Nebraska Movement. References. Carrot. Old Courthouse. History of Buffalo. Chuck Lacusa. Archived from the original on August 8, 2007. Retrieved March 8, 2008. Illinois pp. Free Soil Banner. Indianapolis. Marion County Public Library. American Abolitionists and Anti-Slavery Activists. Comprehensive list of abolitionist and anti-slavery activists and organizations in the United States, including the Free Soil Party. Website includes historic biographies and anti-slavery timelines, bibliographies, etc. Texts on Wikisource. Free Soil Party. Encyclopedia Americana 1920. Libertarian Smaller 2. American 1969. American Freedom. American Populist. America's American Solidarity. Black Riders. Liberation. Christian Liberty. Citizens. Communist Constitution. Democratic Socialists. Freedom Road. Socialist Freedom. Socialist Humane. Independent American Justice. Legal Marijuana. Now Marijuana. Modern Whig National Socialist Movement. New African Black Panther. New Black Panther. Objectivist Pacifist. Peace and Freedom. Pirate. Progressive Labor. Prohibition. Reform. Revolutionary Communist. Socialism and Liberation. Socialist. Socialist Action. Socialist Alternative. Socialist Equality. Socialist Workers Unity. Veterans. Working Families. Workers World. World Socialist. Former Parties. America First. American Know Nothing. American 1924. American Nazi. American Vegetarian. Anti-Masonic. Black Panther. Boston Tea. Citizens. Commonwealth. Land. Constitution. 1952. Constitutional Union. Democratic Republican. Farmer. Labor. Federalist. Free Soil. Gold. Democrats. Greenback. Independence. 2007. Labor. 1919. Labor. 1996. Liberal. Republican. Liberty. National. Republican. National. States. Rights. National Union. 1864. Natural Law. New Alliance. New Union. Nullifier. Opposition. Populist. People's. Personal Choice. Progressive. 1912. Progressive. 1924. Progressive. 1948. Raza. UNITA. Readjuster. Silver. Silver. Republican. Socialist. Socialist. Labor. States' Rights. Dixiecrat. Unconditional Union. Union. 1936. Unionist. 1850s, 60s. U.S. Labor Whig Youth International won at least 100,000 registered party members nationwide, two fewer than 100,000 members state and local political parties without national body presidential nominating conventions. Politics of the United States Politics Portal.